But first, the filmmaker behind one of the more widely anticipated and potentially controversial movies of the year is now at the center of his own controversy, touching on sexual assault, consent, and race. In a year when Hollywood's troubles with diversity have been well chronicled, actor and director Nate Parker's film, Birth of a Nation, promised to be a breakthrough. But Parker's own tangled past has changed the conversation. Jeffrey Brown has the story.
Brethren, I pray you sing a new song.
The Birth of a Nation tells the story of Nat Turner, who led a bloody slave rebellion in Virginia in 1831.
The Lord has spoken to me. Visions of what's to come. A rise of good against evil.
What are we gonna do?
We'll fight. But once it begins, our brothers and sisters will join. And we'll number in the hundreds, thousands even.
36-year-old Nate Parker wrote, directed, and starred in the movie, which first wowed audiences last January at the Sundance Film Festival. Parker spoke of his motivation.
You know, when people ask me who I wanted to be like, I'd say Nat Turner. So about 2 years ago, I stepped away from acting and said the next film I'm involved with would be The Birth of a Nation.
The film won the Audience Award and the Grand Jury Prize at Sundance. Fox Searchlight bought its rights for a festival record $17.5 million, and its national release is due in October. But earlier this month, headlines emerged about a 1999 rape allegation made against Parker when he was a student at Penn State. The alleged victim claimed she'd been unconscious. Parker was charged and later acquitted. Parker's friend and Birth of a Nation co-writer Gene Celestin was also accused in the case. He was convicted, but the verdict was overturned on appeal. In a recent interview with Variety magazine, Parker reiterated his claim that the sex was consensual. 17 years ago, he said, I experienced a very painful moment in my life. It resulted in it being litigated. I was cleared of it. That's that. 17 years later, I'm a filmmaker. The remarks struck a nerve, especially after the revelation days later that the alleged victim had killed herself in 2012. Last week, in his first interview since learning about the suicide, Parker changed his tone, telling Ebony magazine, I was acting as if I was the victim, and that's wrong. My only thought was I'm innocent and everyone needs to know. I didn't even think for a second about her. Sundance, I love also last week, the American Film Institute canceled a screening of the movie.
And we explore some of the issues surrounding this now with Roxane Gay, writer, author of the essay collection Bad Feminist, and associate professor at Purdue University. And Mike Sargent, chief film critic for Pacifica Radio and co-president of the Black Film Critics Circle. Welcome to both of you. Let me start with you, Roxane Gay. You wrote recently, I am struggling to have empathy for Nate Parker, a man experiencing the height of his career while being forced to reckon with his past. So explain that. Was there a conflict of emotions when you first learned of this?
Absolutely. You know, when you follow someone's career trajectory and you see them at the height of their career with a critically acclaimed film that sold for a record amount of money at Sundance, of course I want, you know, him to do very well. I want the movie to succeed. But I cannot overlook these allegations against him. He was acquitted, yes, but his handling of the incident troubles me. The fact that the incident occurred at all troubles me. That he's still friends with the man with whom he was accused troubles me. And so I want to have empathy for him, but I have far more empathy for the victim and for the truth.
Mike Sargent, I assume you were first aware of the film as a filmmaker yourself and film critic. What were your thoughts when you learned about this?
Well, I was conflicted on many levels because as a filmmaker, you know, it's great to see a black filmmaker get to make something. Black historical dramas are not an easy thing to, A, get made, and they don't generally do too well. As a film critic, of course, I want to support black filmmakers, but I'm also a father of a daughter who's in college. So this strikes a particular chord with me. And similar to Roxane, his handling of it and his attitude about it, I mean, he is, after all, a storyteller, and very often we tell ourselves stories that we begin to believe. So I am conflicted. I can't say I won't see the film. I definitely will. But No, I don't think that he's doing what he could and probably should in terms of atoning for what has happened.
Well, so Roxane Gay, what should he be doing? I mean, you and what should we as audience members do? You and others have said this raises an old question, right? About what can you love the art even while you hate or disdain or whatever the artist?
Absolutely. It's really challenging. And I myself, as I wrote in my editorial for The Times, cannot separate the art and the artist, or I choose not to. But I do think we have to have a conversation about restorative justice, because as a culture, we do not know how to achieve justice for victims of sexual violence. And I don't think that someone's life should end because they commit a crime, but I do want to see atonement. I do want to see him having more self-examination about the role that he played that night, because there was a third man there, and he recognized that it was a bad situation and that this young woman was probably in no position to consent, and he walked away.
But can I just interrupt you for a second? Because
yes.
A bad situation, but at least legally, no crime committed, because it's worth saying again, found not guilty.
Well, legally, lots of things are allowed that shouldn't be allowed. It was more than a mistake. I consider it to have been a crime. I think that when a woman is passed out drunk, she cannot consent, and that sex should not be on the table in any way, shape, or form. I call it rape. We don't know what happened that night, but I do think that I would like to see just more acknowledgement. And the interview that Parker did with Ebony is a step in the right direction, but it was also the kind of interview where you can tell that he was really well coached by a publicist. Mm-hmm. And he was saying most of the right things while also just acknowledging that he has never really thought about gender. Yeah. And that he didn't really think about the victim ever. And that troubles me.
Mike Sargent, what about this question of the art versus the artist, and especially in a case like this, as you both have said, the role of race in both the film and the filmmaker?
Well, I think the role of race is undeniable. I mean, you know, there are definitely filmmakers who have done very, very more than questionable things, whether it's a Roman Polanski or a Woody Allen, and they've gone on to not only have long careers but win Oscars. But the question does become, can you separate the artist from the art, and should you? And at what point have you atoned? At what point, what could and should he be doing? That is a good question. I mean, I have my own ideas of what I think he should do and how I think he should address it. But again, like Roxane said, he's being coached. He's being held. There's a way he needs to present himself so that they can still do well with this film.
Mike Sargent, it was announced today that there's going to be a press conference that he's speaking at the Toronto Film Festival in a few weeks. What would you like him to say?
Well, for me, I would like him to as Roxane mentioned, I'd like some more self-examination. I mean, let's look at this for a little bit. I mean, even if he himself feels that he did not commit this act, and if he felt it was consensual, you know, she went under after that what would be termed bullying after that. She became a victim. Now, that is something, as a man and as a father, and he's got daughters, you know, this is something he needs to address. All of it. How do we handle these things? How should young men treat themselves? There are a lot of things that he could be doing and a lot of things he could be addressing in regards to this whole matter, because this matter is something that it's not just about race. It's specifically about gender, but it's also about, once you have, let's say, been acquitted of this, that doesn't mean you can turn your back on it. There was still something he was involved in that ended up contributing to a woman's death.
Well, so let me just ask finally, Roxane Gay, will you see the film? Do you think others should see the film?
I am not going to see the film, no. But I do think that people should do what they want to do. The reality is that he's not the only person that worked on this movie. There is an entire cast and crew that put a lot of work and a lot of really thoughtful work into the making of this movie. And so I am in no way suggesting that other people should not. I just cannot personally do it for many reasons, both personal and just ethical.
And Mike Sargent, briefly, will you see the film?
Well, as a film critic, I really have to see the film, you know? I have to be able to see the film. I have to be able to judge it on its own merits as a film, but I can't ignore what happened behind it, and I can't ignore the history behind the filmmaker.
Mike Sargent and Roxane Gay, thank you both very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.